Hi and welcome to this tutorial where I will show you how to import your custom textures into Death Stranding. For that we will need a few tools like the NVIDIA Texture Tool Exporter, which comes with two versions, the standalone one and the Photoshop plugin. I will use this one because I will use Photoshop. And you will need ID Diamond Raw Texture Previewer and Converter Tool, which I will explain you what it does when we will use it. You will also need the JVS Decima Explorer tool to extract and repack Death Stranding files. And if you've got the PS4 version of the game, you can also download this tool by ID Diamond to allow you to extract and convert 3D models and textures. But if you do so, I strongly recommend you to use this Python script, which will automatically do the work for you. Just follow the tutorial and it will save you a lot of time. To import into 3ds Max the generated ASCII files, you will need this tool by Mario Kart 64, which you can download right here, and I will show you how to import a 3D model into 3ds Max. You will need to go to your Death Stranding folder and the data one. Now, I need to make a backup of the bin file I will edit, which I already does. Most of the time, you will edit this bin file. So just make a backup. Now, we will extract all the files from the game. So just select the data folder. And as you can see, all the game files are right here. So you can extract everything or just some of the files. We will extract everything, so just Ctrl plus A to save everything and press extract. I've already done this right here, and now we need to find the file we will work with. So just go to DS. It's a 3D model related file because it's a texture, so we just go into model folder. It's a file from a character. This character is Sam, and it's a texture file we want to work with. So as you can see, there is a bunch of core files related to the textures, but those are not the texture files. It's more like a container which says to the game, okay, if you want the textures and all the info related to some eyes, then just read me first, and then I will show you all the necessary info to data of the eyes. Like this string is the exact path of one of the eyes texture. So yeah. The core files are not the file we are targeting, it's more like a container of info. So now I need to find which file to work with. And for that I already have the PS4 version extracted, and all the textures are already extracted using the tools I showed you before. And I know the texture I want to edit would be this one, which is Sam's t-shirt albedo textures when he's in his private room. But this is not the real file name, so for that we will just need to read the corresponding core file to extract the real texture file. So just copy the file name, paste, and search for the file. Okay. So as you can see, many information we don't really care about right now, but we care about all the files looking like this. So starting by SM and ending by 001. If I have to manually extract all the paths, doing this it will take so much time and it will be boring. So what I usually do is just open it in Notepad++. Ctrl F to to search for, put the search into the regex mode, and search for all the strings starting by SM and ending by 001. As you can see, it automatically selects the file name I want to extract. So, what to do now? I need to use this tool to extract every texture. I made a batch file to make it easier. So as you can see, you just need to copy the tool name, add the E argument to extract, the path to the data folder, which contains all the bin files, which is right here, and the path to our file. So we need to carefully copy and paste. Don't forget to add .core.stream, otherwise it will not work. And as we have three files to extract, let's just copy this line three times. Copy the new file name, paste, copy, and paste. Just save, and now we can just run this test script. And as you can see, it extracts every file. So now you can see I've got a brand new folder, which is exactly the path of the texture we just extract. Those stream files are the raw data texture, but as you can see, there is not a header. So when a software or human reads those files, they don't know if it's a DTS file or JPEG or whatever. They don't know the resolutions and the format or anything. So what do we need now is just the raw text tool by ID Diamond, and just drag and drop the texture over this tool, and it will automatically try to detect the size, so height, width, and the format. And if we open it into Photoshop, we can see it tried to do something, but it's not the right one. So I know the width is 2048 and the format is BC7 for this specific texture. And if we update, you can see we've got our file. So now I would like to know which part of the texture I can edit to make it look exactly how I want. So I will just run the Mario Kart tool. So this is a 3D file extracted by the ID Diamond tools from the PS4 version, which I will just open right now. Now we need to delete all the bones because we don't need, and the unnecessary other data. Okay, so which one is a good one? Just check the UV of the model. Okay, so as you can see here, we've got a cross-like part, and we find it right here. But in the 3D, it's upside down, and we just need to flip it vertically. And now we can see it's okay. So I want to edit the belly part of the model. So I select the belly part, and I see where is this button on the texture, so it's right here. So now let's just delete our texture. Okay, so now what we do is just merge all the layers and extract as DTS file. So just and if you remember when we extract the texture from the raw texture tool, we saw the format of the texture was the BC7. So just select BC7, but you can see some more information about all the formats, like BC4 is for grayscale texture, BC5 is for normal maps, BC6 doesn't have alpha layer, BC7 have, etc, etc. So just take BC7, just follow my settings, yeah. And just save. Okay, so now if we come here, we got our custom texture, and if we open both the original file and our custom one, we can see something different. Like you see here, so this is the Death Stranding file, which is only raw DTS data, and here we've got all those bytes, which is the header. So as I told you before, this header told us it's a DTS file, which got the units, the height, and other info like the format and everything. But to make it work for the standing, we need to delete the header. And if you have DX10 header file, the header will be 148 bytes long. So just delete all those bytes and save as our default file. Okay, just replace, and here we are. If you have another format like DXT5, the header will be 80 bytes long. So now we've got our brand new file, and now we need to drag and drop our DS folder over the repack, and as you can see, we've got our new custom file into this repack folder, and we need to repack everything now. We will use the decimal for our tool with the repack argument. The path to the bin file we need to edit, which is this one, and the path to our repack folder, which is right here. Just save and run the repack. Now we've got a brand new file. As you can see, the size changed, and if we start the game, we should see our new texture. And as you can see, our brand new texture is working in game. So let me know your feedbacks in the comments, and if you are also doing some modding, please let me know in the comments below, and see you next time.